here's how we fix that. You have to bring everything in your life under the lordship of Jesus Christ. What does that mean? Job number one, I've been given the ministry of reconciliation. That's my job. That's job number one. How does my house fit into that goal? How can I use my car to accomplish that mission? Is my other job, because they've got an earthly job too, is it helpful to accomplishing that mission, or is it a distraction? Is my money helping accomplish the mission of reconciling the world to God, or am I just stockpiling comfort and security for myself? See, your identity isn't wrapped up in all this stuff. Your identity is that you are a reconciler on a holy mission sent out by Almighty God, and if the stuff doesn't help you get where you're going, get rid of it. If saving up for that nice car is preventing you from giving to the church, car's gotta go. If your big, nice house is putting too much strain on your finances so that you can't serve the Lord because you're spending all of your time at work trying to afford your lifestyle, it's time to downsize and surrender that lifestyle to the lordship of Jesus Christ. If your job is working you more hours and keeping you away from the Lord's house and the Lord's people and preventing you from being a godly husband, wife, father, or mother that you're called to be in your home, quit that job and trust the Lord to provide you with another one. Because everything in your life revolves around one thing and one thing only. How can you best accomplish your mission to be a minister of reconciliation? Everything else comes underneath that. God only ever had one true covenant keeper, one who had inherited the blessings of the mountain of the covenant keeper. Only one true God lover, only one perfect God glorifier, and he laid all of the curses of the covenant breaker on his head, and he treated him as guilty so that no one can bring a charge against his elect. This is so that nobody could ever come to us and say, you still owe God something. God took all of that and put it on Jesus. All of our bills were paid, past, present, and future. All of our debt has been erased. All our crimes against the God of the universe have been forgiven. All of our sentences have been pardoned. All of our treason has been forgotten because he became a curse for us.